Fill her up.
You're listening to the Gas Digital Network.
I want to start right away with that comment because it's like, we cannot let your mom start a podcast. She'll blow past us so quickly. Mm-hmm. It'll embarrass us.
Yeah, I know.
She is such a character, dude.
I know.
Don't even let her see the equipment. You look amazing right now.
No,
she, your mom started a podcast on the equipment that you're using.
Yeah. She'd blow up.
She'd blow up, dude.
This looks so nice. I literally look like I'm telling an assault story.
You look so good. I'm floored. I feel like I need to interview you on a really serious subject.
Okay. Let's intro the podcast first.
Okay.
Hit it, Frank.
Welcome to another episode of Prime Motherfucking Topics. I'm your host, Kim Congdon, here with my co-host,
Alex Scarlato. Kimmy, you're making me look ugly today.
You know what I think? I don't like it because it's showing too much detail.
You think so?
Yeah, I think it's a lot.
No, I think you look good in HD. You should always be in HD to show this fucking world that you don't need some fucking shit to cover up any flaws. There you are. Right.
This is me
in 4K looking
amazing. Didn't even brush my hair today.
Wow. I brushed my hair today and desperately wished I brought a hairbrush so that I could brush it again before the show. And I didn't.
Back of my hair looks like a nightmare probably. But yeah, what's up, Alex?
Nothing much, Kimmy. I slept at my parents' house last night. It was my first day out after being sick with not COVID, apparently, for like 8 days and missing Christmas. I had dinner with my parents and we exchanged our gifts and everything. And Harrington came over, and before bed, I read Harrington out loud. I read him the Polar Express, and we both started crying on the same page.
No. Yes. You guys are disgustingly meant to be. I wish you guys could see how Alex is going to hate me saying this. How passionate her and Harrington are for each other.
But it's funny because I keep seeing like comments online of people being like looks like Alex gave up and started dating Harrington, like all these mean comments, and I'm like, if they only knew how Harrington treats me, it's, you couldn't even imagine. I don't
Alex
know what to
hasn't
say.
Had to lift her finger for like 5 years. I don't know what to say,
truly. And I've only been dating him for like 5 months.
Yeah, he's always been nice to you.
He's been so nice to me.
Except for when you guys first met and he was mean, and then I didn't like him. Remember, I didn't used to like Harrington because he was mean to you.
And specifically, something that you said to him shifted his behavior toward me, and it stayed like that forever. It was when we were in Vegas together for Lewis's fight a few years ago.
Mm-hmm.
He was like, Harrington was being a dick because he was like constantly hitting on me around mm-hmm. that time. I was like, dude, you got to stop.
Right.
I just want to be friends. And he like took it badly, and he was just fucking mean and like a total nightmare. And something that Kim said to him, just like it clicked. And he was like, if I ever want this to be a thing, I should probably be nice.
That's what I said. I said, you're not going to make her like you by being mean to her.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
You said it in front of 10 of our friends in the middle of a Vegas casino, just like embarrass him.
Be nice.
Thank you, Kimmy. Like, truly.
What do you want me to say?
Who would not want Kim as a friend? She literally will do that in front of people. It's amazing. There's no better feeling when you feel like you can't defend yourself and somebody just fully says everything that you couldn't even think to say.
Well, the thing is, you got to say it sometimes. People need to be called out. There's certain people that just need to be called out. And now I have a list. Here we go. Number one. I'm just kidding.
Just repeating last week's episode.
Yeah. Last week's episode, really, the comments. Someone sent me a Reddit link where people are wondering who we're talking about, and everyone thinks it's Sherrod. And I'm here now to say it is not Sherrod. Every week we will cross one name off the list. You just keep listening to the podcast.
I will confirm with Yeah, with 100% honesty from my heart, no way it's Sherrod.
No fucking way it's Sherrod.
Sherrod's good vibes, dude.
Sherrod's great vibes. I've never not had a great time hanging out with Sherrod.
Yeah, same.
Yeah, the chat said Sherrod rules.
Oh, man.
I'm so stoned. I feel like this camera really captures it.
Well, I didn't notice that you said it, but now I'm there with you and seeing it. But listen, we can't focus on that kind of shit. It's like, what kind of podcast will this be?
Yeah.
I don't know if you saw my email before the show, but, and I'm sure you came across this girl's TikTok account, but I want to discuss the woman. And G Mike, if you could take us to the video that's in the article first, because that's like the main video that she like kind of blew up for. Have you seen the woman who is dancing in front of her sick baby after she gave birth to it at the hospital?
No.
No?
Literally, we mean you just wait on this podcast. You have to wait a second. Not everything comes quickly. Oh. She is not.
So people have like come after her for that, because like everybody's like, obviously people are like, how tasteless, like read the fucking room, bitch. This is your child.
Literally, and read the room. Your child's in the room sick.
Kim, the way that this woman has doubled fucking down.
Oh, she dances harder.
Doubling down, dancing harder, talking about the sick baby in the comments and dancing harder. And it's like aside from the sick baby, aside from the fact that the baby is sick, this woman just gave birth. And I haven't seen somebody hit moves as fucking hard as she is. It's like her insides. I imagine like her insides being like if you drank half of a Yoo-hoo from like one of those like cardboard containers and then just shook it around.
You know what had me feeling like that? I saw a TikTok of an 18-year-old girl that had a baby and then got pregnant 8 days after she had the baby.
That's too much.
And I'm like, imagine that baby growing in that old stretched out womb that just was freshly lived in. It's like moving into an apartment that hasn't been cleaned out yet from the last landlord.
Yeah, that's gross.
It's like other people's hairs in the sink and shit.
I'm not even about like, I mean, I don't have kids yet, but it's like, I don't think I would even have sex for like a few months after I gave literal birth.
Listen, I'm fucking it.
I need a month and a half or two.
No, yeah, I need a month and a half. I need some time before like, it's probably so traumatic.
I could have done the whole podcast while watching this woman's TikTok. I swear to God.
It was just in the background. She was just dancing with her sick baby.
She's holding the sick baby in her arms and shaking her, like twerking her ass. This woman is out of control.
She also is like using angles and like really spending time. Let me tell you, I've been trying to do TikToks lately and it's been going
a ring light in the delivery room. Yeah.
She brought a ring light. She also like, this takes time and editing and like cuts and angles.
Multiple takes.
Yes. Yeah. So she's doing transitions.
Like imagine the nurse walking in while you're dancing in front of your dying baby.
That's hilarious. Have you seen Long Neck? The guy that calls himself Long Neck?
No.
G Mike, if you can find it, Long Neck Delivery Room Dance TikTok. And if that video pops up, this guy is, I can't believe a human let him come inside of them.
Okay, so he's the father in this delivery room circumstance.
Yes, and he's like so skinny. I guess he used to go viral like a lot. And he's so skinny.
I already know I'm going to hate this video because I just sort of feel like it should be an honor for a man to be invited into a delivery room to begin with. I don't care if you're the fucking sperm donor or not.
Yeah. And if you're dancing.
Is this
you cannot dance in my delivery room. I will kill you.
No, but that is him. That's not the video, but that is him.
Hold on. Is that his girl?
No, no. I think his girl's pretty.
No, that girl was beautiful.
I know. That girl, his girl makes that girl look like she was found at the bottom of the ocean.
Do you think people are dating people like way fucking different than them just for clout on TikTok? Because we were talking about that just me and you FaceTiming this week about that old saggy woman who's dating the hot young black dude.
Yes.
You think it's
the one where all the comments were killing us, all the TikTok comments. Me and Alex just called each other and then we read TikTok comments about this. There's this old leathery face lady. Like she looked like, I swear to God, she looked like cracks in the concrete. Like she looked like,
you give me 30 seconds. I have the link to this TikTok and I'm sending it to G Mike. I can't even not bring this up. I don't know what to say. This TikTok entertained me for 2 hours because the roast jokes were just too fucking good.
The jokes were so good.
It's like, reading the comments on TikTok is obviously the best part.
I think it's part of the culture.
It truly is. I spent an hour and a half in this comment section, by the way. Why is my copy paste not working?
When we say wait a minute on the podcast, we literally mean wait a minute.
Oh, yes. Yeah, you are going to have to edit this out.
What's going on?
we both got too high to continue the conversation after I sent Mike something. And I truly do need him to edit out at least 10 or 15 seconds of that dead air, because it's like we forgot we were doing a podcast.
I think I looked at my phone. Did I look at my phone?
Because another thing you have to remember is that like Kim and I talk to each other like literally like three times a day. Like we like FaceTime each other three times a day. And sometimes we do that thing where you just literally forget that the other person's there for like 20 minutes and then you come back to the conversation.
There have been a few times where I'm just living my life and Alex talks and I jump. I'm like, oh shit, bitch, I forgot you were here. I could have been, who knows? I did that with G Mike last podcast. Sometimes you just forget you're on camera. It's scary.
I've done that before.
Sorry, go ahead.
I was just going to say, I've literally seen you naked in the last week because you kind of forgot that we were on FaceTime.
Yeah, I gave you a mouthful of titty.
Yeah, you gave me a good mouthful of titty, sister.
You're welcome.
Thank you. sorry, I forgot to thank you.
It's okay.
Yeah, but it's like we can't be getting the levels of high that we forget that we're doing the podcast and we go into like just regular FaceTime mode. It's a problem.
For sure. Here she is. Oh my God. Okay. You think I'm scared? I ran 3,300 miles away. First of all, before we start the video, with my seven children for an abusive relationship to be free.
Yeah, it's a really important note that is what this video is about, okay? It's just her posing along with this song, and it says, "You think I'm scared? I ran 3,300 miles with my seven children from an abusive relationship to be free." It is serious.
And I will add to this, she has to be Sue's cousin.
Yes. Okay. She has
Sue energy. She has
Sue energy.
If you watched our episode called Sickly Sue, if you haven't, you need to go fucking watch it right away. Alex and I did a tab of acid and decided to go garage sailing in Florida. And we ran into this lady at a trailer park named Sue. She gave Alex all of Alex's wardrobe. Basically,
she gave me all of her belongings. She said, "You are the same size I used to be."
Because she was sickly.
Yeah, no, she hasn't. By the way, she did not gain weight. She lost so much weight from what I am now that she can't fit in the clothes anymore.
Yeah.
And she was like, "I leave everything to you."
And it all was like Alex's style, because like this lady was wearing like hippie stuff on, ironically. Like it just had, she had it literally, it's literal vintage.
It's that Alex hippie got. Shit from the 70s. It's fucking sick.
Yes, this it's woman, real vintage.
This woman is like if Susan like really got hooked on the bad drugs for a long time.
This is like if Sue stayed sick but never died.
This is Sickly Susan in 20 years.
Yeah.
While she keeps smoking cigarettes. That was another thing about her. Go back and listen to the episode. But like, she made it a point to be like, yep, doctor, my ex-husband, everybody says I need to stop smoking cigarettes, but I ain't gonna, because cancer's cancer and cigarettes are cigarettes.
Like, she did say that. And as we were just finishing up loading all of her shit, like literally her entire house into our car, we were all on acid. So we thought we were hitting a lick. And we put all this stuff in as we like almost as we loaded the last thing in, she's like, yeah, I done coughed blood on everything. Like, what?
Fucking wild, dude. So, we double washed it all.
Yeah.
It was So anyway, Susan's cousin is here. She's been through some shit.
This is play the TikTok.
Yeah. Never said I'm never scared.
Okay.
With okay. Zero CGI whatsoever. She could literally play something in like a scary movie like The Grudge. Yeah, like she could be like an old woman who's demonically possessed.
If I was a casting agent, I was casting for a horror film, I'd call her up and say, "Let's see what she's like in front of a camera." She can obviously TikTok.
I'd say, "Honey, you're a star."
You're a star, a shriveled fucking dying star. So let's see what the comments are.
Man, you have to log in to see the comments, but I literally have it right here. So I'm just going to take you through them real quick.
Okay.
I mean, the top comment is, did that happen 15,000 years ago? Seniors who started vaping as freshmen. I like it when the comments are like typed out a little ghetto. Sometimes it just makes it funnier.
Like
this
what?
One says, "Use was running from dinosaurs too."
Give me another. Give me the top one.
Damn, she pre-ordered the Bible. Was this before the American Revolution started? Somebody just goes, "I'm fighting for my spot in heaven every day."
It's so good.
The only person I trust with my history class homework. She's seen it all. Been running since the Byzantine Empire. Bro helped write the Ten Commandments. She wrote on Noah's Ark.
Oh, it's and good.
Just goes, the disrespect y'all have, SMH.
This woman is talking about being abused.
I mean, and I felt bad and everything, but it's like, that's the thing about the internet. You cannot put yourself out there without the possibility of some backlash. And like, if you have any kind of self-awareness, if I was this woman, I would not be posting, is what I'm saying. And I'm proud of her for posting, but it's also our right as Americans to make fun of her.
Yeah.
Or to at least gain joy from other people making fun of her.
Yeah.
Because I spent like an hour and a half in that comment section cackling, going back to the video, going back to the comments, back to the video.
It is good.
On a loop, sister.
You are stuck in a Sickly Sue's cousin loop. One of the worst loops to get stuck in, they say.
I don't know, man. I promise you that she lives in Florida. I just promise you.
I've been wanting to do one of those TikToks that's like,
I know this one.
You know that one?
Yeah.
If you don't understand what I'm saying, it's literally, that's just the audio. It does that. And then people put things at like your parents' fridge when you come home, and it'll be like old dressings and like a bag of like nuts and like a weird like keto snack. And it's like, they'll do each picture in each frame and go like, oh. And it's like the loneliest, echoiest audio. It just
it's
sounds
like an unsettling, like childish kind of lonely audio to show off things that could be better.
It emotionally brings me is it emotionally brings me to like, if you were a child stuck in purgatory.
Right.
Isn't that's the feel of the audio. So it goes,
the feel of the audio. Yeah. It's like each thing, it's like the desire for the thing to be fun combined with the realization that it isn't. And it's all of that is encapsulated in each one of these little echoing sounds.
How
does it's actually work? Amazing.
It's actually, it's fun. This is a podcast about science. I don't know if you guys know that. We're actually talking about very smart things. You've ever listened to Joe Rogan? This is like the woman version of Joe Rogan. Whoa, we're looking up the science behind week.
That audio does definitely, if we were to put our brains under a brain scanner, I promise you that
it would bring up traumatic dark memories.
Does something to your brain where it's like, yep, I've been there. Just that time that I thought things were going to be awesome and then the day sucked.
Yeah, it's so weird.
Yeah.
I don't get it, but
it's like a play date being canceled when you were looking forward to it all week as like a 6-year-old.
You know,
it's
something which one, like that. You know which audio on TikTok fucks me up? The one that's like it'll always talk about like things that are unfound in the ocean, and it's like this like
Yeah, that audio is purposefully demonic.
The Game of Thrones one that goes, oh, hold on, God,
it goes like, heave ho.
Yes.
And beggars is fucked up. Yeah.
It gives me goosebumps just hearing it.
They use it to show you like fears, usually like fear of massive things. The person who posted is so annoying, by the way, because the person who that account is like, When I say I have fear of large things, I don't mean these kinds of things. And then it shows you like an SUV. Like,
yeah.
Really normal things that nobody's afraid of. And then he flips it to like what the fear actually is. And the comment section every time is like, who would be afraid of those first things?
The comment section is why TikTok is so successful. The comment section is so funny, dude. Did we talk about the grandma's ass?
Yes. We talked about it between the two of us, not on the show, I don't think.
Oh, there was this
where the dude who came home from 16 years in prison, and there's a series of him like meeting with each of his family members for the first time.
Yeah, and it's supposed to be sweet.
Yeah, but grandma's getting a little extra attention.
Yeah, because she has this dress on and her ass looks so, she's like old and kind of like fat.
She has like a house dress on that like a Black or Italian grandmother would be wearing at any point.
Yes. Or a Hispanic. Anybody or besides Hispanic. A white grandmother.
Anybody who's not a white grandmother would wear these dresses.
Yes. And she is walking in it and her ass is like almost like clapping in the cheeks of the dress as so she's it's walking.
Like the dress has like natural pleating to it, but like one of those pleats, like to the naked eye, you wouldn't notice, but one of those pleats fits perfectly in her ass crack.
And the way the fabric's designed perfectly curves her body. Yeah, it was a beautiful dress.
But when she is as excited as she is to see her grandson for the first time in 16 years, she starts jumping up and down.
And it starts
her booty be clapping.
I was like, damn, my phone started vibrating.
There was not one person in the comments who didn't need to address it. I swear to God.
Yeah. Every single person said like, damn, people are clapping and the movie didn't even stop yet. and it's talking about grandma. It's talking about, I saw another comment saying every day I fight for my spot in heaven. Like that's a big one. I also love the TikToks that will be people in love, and it'll show like the cutest, most romantic TikTok video. And then you go to the comments and someone says, I hope my next blink is my last.
Yeah. If someone's like time to take a bath with my toaster.
Yes. Yeah. It's so funny.
So depressing.
Oh, it's really great. The internet's unmatched, truly. I can't believe we've lived without.
And it's like, and also I need to also like do this PSA that I truly believe that like TikTok is fucking with my brain and like not making me have a shorter attention span and like unable to like sit down and watch a full length movie. I don't care.
A movie feels like 3.5 years when you're watching it. By the time we're in the second act of the movie, I'm like, this should be over. The whole thing's about, we know what's going to happen in the third act and we know how it's going to come around. So let's just cut the fat. can we cut movies down? I say every feature film should be 45 minutes. Ideal.
Dude, I get that. When I was sick last week, I spent like, literally I was spending like 4 hours at a time on TikTok. And then I'd be like, I should stop doing this and transition to a movie. And I was like, go already, dude, do the thing. I can't be funny. Like, scare me.
Like, scare me. Be funny. Please. Quick.
I just want to feel something new every minute, please.
Yeah, it takes a long. And then when someone puts on a movie, now when someone wants to watch a movie and they're like, it's kind of long, I'm like, no, because movies are long. So I'm not watching a long movie. Are you fucking insane? A 3-hour film like The Irishman.
You couldn't pay me to watch The Irishman. I don't care how good it is, by the way.
Me neither.
Don't come at me for this. You couldn't pay me to sit down and watch The Irishman.
Me neither. 4 hours? No.
If I'm going to watch a 3-hour movie, it has to have,
two and a half hours of me. A minimum.
It's so funny because I was going to say it has to have the hottest person ever in it. That's literally what I was going to say. Because like I could watch Titanic. I watched Titanic like 3 weeks ago.
And me too.
It flew by because because everybody in it's so hot. I'm just like horny watching Titanic for 3 hours and it flies by.
Yes. But The Irishman's like a dude walk. And like one of the shots is like literally a full minute and a half of like a dude's walking stick in the dirt. And then,
it
pans up
for men.
Yeah.
I know, yes. By the trailer when a movie is fully made for men and people and men are gonna be like, what a great film, it was so deep. I'm like, no, it wasn't. It was,
it's just the only place you are allowed to have your emotions, and you had 3 hours to feel emotional over dirt.
I'm glad you felt something.
Good.
Not for me. I'm sorry.
Good. Stop raping.
Please
stop raping.
Watch another movie.
Watch another movie.
Yeah. Yeah, that The Irishman is not for me. I can't even think of another movie that I think of like that, but there's got to be so many where I'm like,
oh, Lord of the Rings.
I've told you that my mom and I will still fight to this day if we bring up Lord of the Rings, because when it came, whatever year the first Lord of the Rings movie came out, I must have been like 9 years old, maybe. Mm-hmm. My parents, I think I was younger. What year did that movie come out? I must know. I was born in 93. I need
can
to know
I guess,
how old I
can
was.
I guess, because I like to see if I can remember. If Lord of the Rings must have came out, I feel like when I was a freshman in high school, which would have been.
Nah. There were three.
The Rings came out in December 2001, and then each sequel was a year after that.
I was 11.
2001. Okay. So I was
11.
Eight or nine, depending on the time of year.
Okay. So maybe almost my, okay. So, okay. Okay. Okay.
So maybe in retrospect, I was too old for this behavior, but like my parents were like, we're going to see a movie. It's Lord of the Rings. And I was like, please leave me home with grandma. I don't want to go. And they were like, no, we're going as a family. And I was like, but why take me to see a movie that, you know, I don't want to go see. I was so against it from the moment it came out. That when we went to the movies, I like cried the whole time. And my mom and I still are, whenever we bring it up, it's like a total argument that she's like, you were being a little bitch that day. And I was like, well, you shouldn't have taken me to the movie that I said that I was going to act up during.
Yeah.
I made it very clear that I would not sit still during this movie before we left the house. I was like, I really don't want to see it. I'm not going to like it.
Have you ever seen it?
No.
Me neither. We should watch it with your mom.
Her off
just to piss her off.
We should make her watch it, because you know what, she's gonna say she doesn't want to, and I would love to sit down and force her into watching that movie.
Mm-hmm.
See how she feels.
You can get your ultimate karma on your mother.
We could argue about this, and whichever one feels like we're right will prove the other person wrong
by the other person's experience, and it cancels it out.
We should do it. Mm-hmm. I do feel like that was fully, and I'm sure there's like girls out there who like those movies, but like that's for boys.
Yeah.
Sorry.
And we're not even trying to be like, we'll call you whatever pronouns you want to be called. We don't even really fit gender norms. I wear more boy clothes, I feel like, than girl clothes. But that is for boys. That is for boys. I don't know what else to say. That is for boys. And so is like, what's another one? Don't, if a guy ever wanted me to watch Star Trek, we're not even on the same planet.
I can't tell you how many guys have asked me, and the answer is no, but have asked me the question, have you ever seen Donnie Darko?
No. They love Donnie
Darko. I don't even know what that is. I don't know what it is, but it's for boys.
But it is for boys. Donnie Darko is for boys. The Marvel movies, they said in the chat. The Marvel movies?
Boys.
Don't even get me started on the Marvel movies. They're so bad. Okay, I'll tell you what's good. Spider-Man. Very, very consistently such... Always, the Tobey Maguire one was good. Into the Spider-Verse movie was... I've watched it 6 times on my own. It's so good. And I heard the new one that just came out is good. The Marvel movie, like the what's the one that everyone cried in recently? Avengers. Oh my God. Every scene. They're doing a normal thing, living a normal life. What's that sound? The bad guy breaks in. Things break. He kills the bad guy. He goes away. They go back. Do a normal thing. Love scene. What's that sound? The bad guy breaks in. It's so repetitive over and over and over again.
Yeah,
I cannot believe. Yeah. It's boy TV.
I think it's the male fantasy of like you said, the bad guy comes in.
First of all, men don't speak freely here. Kidding. Yeah,
every guy wants to be that guy where like shit's going down, it's like I'll take care of this, like running towards the danger, and that's why it's like the bad guy comes in and starts to, because every guy's living that through themselves, you know what I mean? Like oh, I'd be the one running towards the bad guy. Like
that actually makes a lot of sense.
But they're
like,
not
out there acting like fucking villains in the world. Like, I can't make up your mind. If you guys all want to be superheroes that bad, then you should all be awesome, amazing men. If the, for the number of people who love Marvel, if that's the reason they love it, then they should all be a little better.
We're really lacking in superheroes and really overcompensating in superhero movie sales.
I've never like looked around in a movie theater at a Marvel movie and seen guys who look like they could protect me if something goes down.
Mike, that has to be what it is. It's some cry of fantasy, and then directors like, the men love this, put 16 of those in 3 hours, 16 of them, and have a girl with huge tits as a character,
and bookend each scene with an explosion beginning
and sure Scarlett Johansson is the lead.
I fuck with Spider-Man too, though, for some reason, and I'm trying to figure out why girls are down with Spider-Man. He's like obviously the most fuckable of all of them, but I can't figure out why, because like the rest of them are made to be good looking, but I wouldn't want to fuck any of them the way I would fuck Spider-Man.
Realize it's the web that he's shooting literally at people. It's the white sticky web that he's shooting everywhere.
I don't know, but it's kind of hot.
We're like, I can't figure out why this guy in like a tight outfit who saves the world and shoots white sticky stuff at you.
Hangs upside down to make out with you.
It's all great. And it's written really well. And the movies just seem different.
Yeah. It's not the same shit every time. It doesn't feel like the hacky ass fucking.
Feels like you're watching a rom-com and a superhero shows up.
Yeah,
almost right.
G Mike saying his girlfriend likes it too.
Yeah,
there we are.
Yep, it's more teen drama like The Breakfast Club. I think that's definitely what it is.
Yeah, I mean, and I get that there's like a massive market for like, but also at the same time, like, there's some shit that I see out there that I look at it and I'm like, equally turned off because I feel like it's very marketed for like girls.
Magic Mike.
Yes, I have never seen that movie.
I would never go watch Magic Mike.
No,
I have no interest in seeing Channing Tatum in a Speedo unless he's in my room.
Yeah, I don't want to watch that on screen. I don't want to go to the movies to get horny, by the way. Like,
no,
not like specifically. I would love to get horny at the movies as like a side effect, but I'm not going there for that.
I would never go watch like a 50 Shades of Grey at the movies.
No, 50 Shades of Grey is another great thing that's like very girl oriented that I'm like, you could not like pay me to watch that.
No, you could not. I like movies that are nice in the middle. I like them to have a little romance, a little action, a little drama, and then move on. Please bring, it's like TikTok. I like the TikTok of movies. Give me all the emotions. If you're going to fill it into an hour 45, give me all the emotions and then let's move on. Name your perfect movie. What's a movie that you think was like so good from beginning to end?
Inglourious Bastards is one of my favorite movies.
I've never seen it, but I'll have to check it out.
So good from beginning to end. Every scene, there's something that makes you feel something. You're either like nervous, you're on edge, you're like,
I love that.
Excited. It's a fucking great movie.
I love that. I think I would say I Am Legend. It was so good. It was so good. I stand by it so strongly.
That's the one with the dog, right?
Mm-hmm.
I haven't seen it.
Can we watch it when I go there?
Sure. I'm
are
like,
are you one of those people?
Not a huge Will Smith fan. Like, I'm like okay with Will Smith, but I like haven't. I feel like there's a lot of people who are like, wow, Will Smith came out with another movie. The whole world better go see it. And he's just not one of those for me.
He's had a couple that I really liked, but I'm not like crazy like, about it. But he's like, good.
He's good.
Pursuit of Happiness. But there's a couple so people great. Who like,
The Pursuit of Happiness is great. I don't know. I'm just like not. I'm not compelled to see every movie that he's in the way that I am with like some other actors. There's really not a lot of actors who I'm like that with though.
What's a movie that's really, really, really bad, but you like?
Oh my gosh. I have to think about it.
I have so many. This is
really,
it's mostly what I watch.
Okay.
I like what bad things. Yours? I love the movie Good Luck Chuck with Dane
I've
Cook.
I've seen that one.
I think it's so funny.
You like a romantic comedy. Like you like a cute romantic comedy.
I like that's not even cute. He's just fucking a bunch of women. It was like really weirdly made, but for some reason I liked it. I really liked it.
Okay. That's fair, man. I'm sure I have one of these, but I cannot think of it right now.
That one with Matthew McConaughey and Kate Hudson, where they're looking for the treasure and they're like in some sort of nice island. And it's just, I watch it purely for the views of the water.
Okay. That's reasonable though. Cause I'll do like a diving movie or stuff like that. Sometimes a good ocean movie.
I love an ocean movie. I love to escape into an ocean movie.
Yeah, ocean movies are okay. And they're kind of novel because it's like there's only so much you could do, I guess, while shooting a movie on the water.
For sure.
Like every one of them kind of feels the same. There's only a few things, different ways you could take the plot, even like what's going to happen in the water.
Yeah.
But it's fun.
Oh, I love
fun
that
almost
one.
Every time.
What is it called? 32 meters down or something, where the girls are a shark. This, and I've thought about this ever since I watched this movie. I'm like, this is something I would never think about while doing it, but it could happen, is that they're cave diving in the ocean and the thing breaks off the boat. And so the cage that they're stuck in sinks to the bottom of the ocean and they have like scuba tanks, but they're at like the bottom of the sea and their scuba tanks are running out. It's such a good movie.
Oh, I've never seen that.
It's not good. It's not even good because they don't even have good audio. Like they can't really talk. It's like mostly silent and underwater, but it does fuck you up.
Well, that's the point, is like, yeah, like the movies are always novel for like one reason or another, where it's like, yeah, they literally can't talk. Everything has to be kind of shown to you, like, or man, you just reminded me of something that I think is so funny.
What?
But I'm like also mildly concerned about it, which is the Gas Digital trip to Jamaica is coming up at the end of the month. And my mom, specifically when I told her I was going to Jamaica, said, and I quote, "Promise me you won't go swimming if you have your period."
Why?
She thinks that a shark is going to smell through my tampon and come get me.
Well, maybe, but
she truly thinks that like the odds of me dying by shark attack are like way up if I have my period. And I'm not sure if that's true.
Can we look it up, G-Mike? Because G-Mike's putting it, first of all, G-Mike's putting in random facts so quickly. I know he's not looking them up. He just said they could smell a drop of blood from a mile away. It's like he got that from, for sure, a Marvel movie. I got to say it. I know a Marvel movie quote when I see one. That's from Spy Kids.
He very dramatically wrote it too, I have to say. In the chat, he wrote, sharks, they can smell blood from a mile away. Sharks was in its own message by itself before the rest of the sentence.
He said, especially period blood, it says. Does it say that for real?
I don't believe him. I don't believe that especially period blood smells stronger.
Can you pull up the article for proof that you're looking at? I don't believe you.
I don't know, man. And I don't think
I made that up.
Oh,
but I don't think true? I'm going to have my at, period that saying, week.
It's saying that sharks cannot smell blood from miles. They are able to smell blood from far away, but they don't like go crazy and attack. Like that's a myth. Like they don't just smell blood and just holy shit and just head over to.
They're not like, wow, I smell one drop of blood that's a mile away. Let me go to it real quick. Like it's one drop of blood. Like that's nothing. It doesn't signify a meal.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm not going to be bleeding out into the ocean, you know?
Yeah, don't free bleed into the ocean. I wouldn't free bleed
in the ocean. I never would, Kimmy. I love the oceans.
I mean, I don't think you would hurt the ocean if you free bled in it. It's probably one of the least harmful acts you could do to the ocean.
No, you're right. I just feel like it would like,
it I would, feel like if we, her, if we all
hurt her free, psyche,
if we all free bled in the ocean more, the corals would come back somehow. why does that make sense in my head?
There would be more dolphins. I don't know.
There'd be like nutrients on the coral somehow and it would start growing again.
There's coral reefs everywhere.
I'll tell you, I went to Jamaica once and I went snorkeling nude. And I think that when you go there, you should do that.
How am I going to go snorkeling nude with all of the rest of the employees at the back of the house there?
Sneak,
I can't.
Sneak off. Like tell them you need a day and go and find a nude beach and go snorkeling nude. It is like, it's like if you guys have a chill day and you have a day where you can go off by yourself, I highly recommend sneaking off. Go with Harrington. Find a nude beach and go snorkeling nude. It feels so good to have beach water in your puss. I hate to say it so unbeautifully.
Not, I'm surprised that that's where this was going. Just I'm shocked, actually.
Just to be able to swim in your butts, like in the ocean. It feels great.
It sounds nice, but I would just like never have thought that anybody would phrase it that way. Because like when you're wearing... Because it's interesting because when you're wearing a bathing suit, it's like the one thing that you're trying to do is keep everything away from your pussy. You're like, because sand gets in there like it's
yeah.
been hired to fucking break into your bathing suit.
Yeah, sand's like a hitman that someone paid to get in there. The way that sand will too, get-
it's like, I'm going to swim into your pussy. I'm going to give it a shot and see if I could impregnate you with fish eggs.
Seaweed's like, I'll take it a step further. I'm going to find the flaps. I'm getting in there.
Seaweed's like, I want to lick her butthole.
Yeah. But yeah, no, when you're in the ocean, you're swimming naked. You almost want it.
You're like, I wish that a gust of
ocean would go in me
of ocean wave would just kind of hit me at the right angle right now.
Yeah, you want to get tapped by the ocean a little,
man. I mean, it seems like it'd be good for you.
It was
a little salt water in the pussy wouldn't hurt.
A little salt water in the puss never hurt nobody.
Well, shit, if that ain't true.
Yeah, but yeah, I don't think your mom has much to worry about.
Well, I just told her that if I have my period, I won't go swimming. And now, regardless of whether or not I have my period, I'm just going to have to tell her that I don't because I'm going swimming either way. And yeah. Also, how funny would it be if I like somehow got attacked by a shark because of my period?
That would be great.
Kind of funny.
And now it's like less likely to happen now that we did this podcast. I think the universe isn't like that.
Yeah.
I think you could sometimes say a thing and they're like, oh, now it'd be obvious if we did it.
Now, if we did it, everybody's going to think that she's a fucking psychic of some sort. We can't give her that.
It's like we haven't moved to the phase of making them public psychics. Please. It's
yet.
Yet.
Man.
Yeah.
We're doing a podcast.
We keep getting high and forgetting.
I forgot for a second again.
You forgot? You thought we were FaceTiming?
For a hot second.
Do you think it's dangerous that we've been FaceTiming too much? It's affecting our podcast?
I don't know. But also we talk about, I don't think so, because 9 times out of 10 when we're FaceTiming, we're talking about stuff that we would never say on the podcast.
And that's not, and it's not funny stuff. It's just stuff we wouldn't,
it's not funny stuff. Yeah. We talk shit with each other. Yeah. We goss. We spill hot tea.
Yeah. Like that unfunny piece of shit from last week's episode. It was not Sherrod.
Yeah. And our enemy show here at Gas Digital.
Our enemy show. Fuck your show. Except your co-host.
Fuck that show.
Your co-host, he's really nice and cool, but fuck you.
Also, we love the producer.
Yeah, but fuck you. Alex can't say fuck you because she also works there. But look at her, and I can see in her heart she feels it.
I think I might have said it like 30 seconds ago. I'm not sure.
I don't know. We got high again.
Shit, now I'm nervous.
Looks, there goes your Jamaican vacation.
No, don't say it.
Oh, man.
Dude, I'm hanging in this job to get myself to Jamaica. And when we come back, we'll see. Imagine I just quit after I hung out just long enough.
That'd be the best way to quit, is if you quit the day after Jamaica.
It's really funny.
And
if
stayed in Jamaica.
Quits. It's so funny if the entire staff quits the day after Jamaica.
But also, they also came together and paid for another week in Jamaica. So they quit. And also we're like, we're also not flying back right now.
We're like, pack your bags. You guys aren't paid for.
Yeah.
You guys have to figure out what's going on with your company.
Look at Alex. This is from her soul. She's living. You're fantasizing how like we used to look like when we were watching Boy Meets World.
Dude, it'd just be so fucked up. Just
why then? Why are you smiling so much?
Because I'm excited to go to Jamaica. That my amazing, amazing bosses are bringing me on this beautiful trip.
Liz is under the table pinching her. Oh fuck, man. Yeah, yeah. I want to go to so many places. You know, I wanted to go to Thailand, but then it's like, you can't do drugs there. Like you can't bring mushrooms to Thailand, right?
No, and I feel that way about a lot of the places that I want to visit. It's like, especially with weed, other drugs I could stay off of, but I don't really want to go on a vacation and not be able to smoke weed. That seems gay. You're not supposed to use gay light anymore. Fuck. Shit. Fuck.
It's actually very straight to have to not be able to go anywhere without smoking weed. It's straighter than it is gay, I feel like.
You guys know what I meant, okay? It's like, don't make me explain myself. Sometimes I just want to talk the way I used to talk when I was like 10, even though it was inappropriate.
Whoa. 20 grams of weed in Thailand, you can face the death penalty.
20 grams? I have that on me right now.
Yeah.
The death penalty, dude. I can't go to Thailand.
But it looks so fun in Thailand. And it's like, you could go and not smoke and you'd probably love it.
Sure. But I think the move would be to do a cleanse before you leave so that you're not like fucking like looking for weed the whole time and feeling like the effects of quitting smoking weed the whole time. You have to quit like 2 months before you go to Thailand.
I don't think 2 months. I think 2 weeks.
You think?
I think 2 weeks before, on the third week, you'd be feeling pretty good.
All right.
It's weed, not heroin. You need
yeah, but
two
I mean, your my appetite gets affected. If I stop smoking, I won't eat for like 2 weeks, like not a big meal like I usually eat.
I know.
You know?
I should stop smoking. Last time I stopped smoking, I lost so much weight. I actually got really sick last time I stopped smoking.
What do you mean?
I was like nauseous for days.
Like, I know, so that's what I'm saying. I wouldn't want to do that while I was on a vacation.
Growing up, we were like, weed is not a hard drug. It should be legalized. And now we're on a podcast like, yeah, I had bad withdrawals last time I tried to get off the stuff. No, I could never step foot in Thailand. They don't let me hit my vape. It's like, Jesus Christ, are we okay? You ever take a step back and be like, maybe it's a harder drug than I thought.
I mean, sort of, but I feel like it it helps my anxiety so much and like makes me like feel like a better person so often that it's like, why am I going to pay to go on a vacation to a place where I can't have this thing that makes my life so much better?
Right.
I don't know. I don't know. I feel like Amsterdam is the answer. It's the Amsterdam. Amsterdam. Okay. Amsterdam.
I used to have a pet Amsterdam.
No, yeah. I've always wanted to go to Amsterdam because like all the drugs are legal there. Like you could just fucking party hard and not worry.
Yeah, that sounds fun, but isn't it cold?
I don't know. And I also picture like just like tourists being the only people who are walking around fucking with saucers for eyes. Like,
yeah.
It's like the way to spot a tourist out there is like the highest people.
It's also like the more free a country is, the colder and more uncomfortable everything else is. It's like, that's the only way they could get people there is they're like, you can do all the drugs you want. And they're like, fine, we'll come. But somewhere like Thailand, it's like, no, don't do any drugs, but we can give you paradise. You have to choose. Isn't that weird?
That is weird. What are drug policies like in Australia? I think there's a good couple pinches of paradise in Australia.
There is. I've seen some really beautiful places in Australia, but I'm scared of the animals. Thailand, it's like Australia, like the fucking everything. It's like a scarier Florida. Everything. The crocs, the snakes, the spiders, the scorpions. The koalas.
Croc sounds like a racial slur.
It really does. We're not going to be able to say croc in a few years, I can tell.
No.
You know, I also wanted to bring this up too, and I hate to bring up TikTok again, but when I said hamster, there's a TikTok video of this girl whose hamsters are sleeping. Uh-huh. And then yep. I saw, and then she called her vet, and her vet's like, they could be hibernating. And now a bunch of people... A bunch of people were saying how they also buried their pet hamsters because they thought that they were dead, but they just found out from that TikTok that it was hibernating. And two, a lot of people talk about how pet hamsters die if they get really too scared, like they easily have heart attacks and die. And so I saw another TikTok and it was a girl just dancing and said, this is fucked up, but please tell me the story. If I hear your hamster died in the comments, I'm bored. They were so funny, dude. The reasons the hamster died were so fucked up. Like the things that hamsters have gone through in history is so tragic. It is so tragic. Like,
especially after learning that half of them just get buried alive.
Well, there's that, and they die so easily. Like they literally fall apart. Like according to the comments, like one girl was like, mine's eyes just fell out and it was just walking around with two sockets for like a week and then it died. And then someone said to mine is like, mine got too cold in my room and its feet fell off. And then another one, like they die in the most tragic way. Another one's like, my sister ran in my room and scared me and I screamed and I scared my hamster and it died. It's like the most tragic things. They die so easily. It's almost comical.
Oh, that's awesome. That's great.
One said my mom tried to pull a tick off mine and it ended up actually being its penis and it killed it from a shock.
No. Why did it have a discolored penis? I have to assume it was discolored for you to think it's a tick.
Yeah, a little white hamster with a big black dick. They're like, that's a tick.
Black.
That ain't a dick. That's a tick. The hamster's like, no, I said it's a dick.
It's a dick. Yeah, no. I have to pay for my parking. My hamster died on the morning of picture day in fourth grade. And my teacher had to pull me aside because I wouldn't, like, I was like crying. They wouldn't send me to go take my picture because I was crying like all day to the point where the teacher had to like take me out of the classroom and tell me about her cat that died and like she told me about all her dead pets in history. I swear to God, it really just made me feel worse.
That's hilarious. You're like, pets die like, so often.
By the end of the conversation, the teacher was sad and I pretended to feel better to try to make her feel better.
Not this cunt putting it on you.
It's like, now I have to just feel better because you tried so hard. Her.
She didn't have to deal with the shit anymore.
Yeah, not bad.
All right, well, let's end the podcast there so you can pay for parking. You guys, thank you so much for listening to this week's episode of Broad Topics. You guys can follow me on Twitter at Kimberly Congdon, on Instagram at Kim Congdon. Check me out on Twitch, twitch.tv/QueenKong1. I will be in New York next week. So excited. Come check me out. I'll be at the Stand. I'll be doing shows at the Brooklyn Comedy Club. I'll be chilling with Alex. We're going to be doing some podcasts. We're going to be a guest on some podcasts. It's going to be a good time. Alex, where can people find you?
You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at I am Alex Scar, and check out Stick and Portly, Watch Rick and Morty every Monday right after Legion of Skanks. It's our me and Harrington's Rick and Morty reaction show. Other than that, head to gasdigitalnetwork.com. If you catch this before the end of the year, you can use promo code TOPIX30 for a 30-day free trial. If not, promo code TOPICS will also get you a free trial. Check out the network. You can watch all of our episodes, including Sickly Susan, on demand whenever you want. It's pretty fucking awesome.
All right. Perfect. We'll see you guys next week. Bye.
Bye.